Cedre Ward. Let's get the official introductions from our ring announcer, the classy Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to the home of the Golden State Warriors, the Oracle Arena in Oakland, California, for this very special event and the featured bout of the evening, brought to you by Goosen Tudor Promotions and Sauerland Promotions in association with Antonio Leonard Productions and Showtime. This bout is sanctioned by the WBA, President Gilberto Mendoza, Supervisor Rudy Tellez, along with the California State Athletic Commission, the Chairman Mario Rodriguez, Interim Executive Officer David Thornton. Our physicians at ringside, Dr. Smith Ketchum, Dr. Gary Furness, timekeepers at the bell, also keeping count of the knockdowns, Ed Coyantes and Valinda Stell. Introducing our three judges scoring this bout from ringside. From South Africa, Stanley Christodoulou. From Sweden, Michael Hook. From California, Steve Morrow. And our third man of the ring, our referee in charge of this bout, Jack Reese. All right, fans, here we go with our main event of the evening, the final bout in stage one of the Super Six World Boxing Classic and 12 rounds of boxing for the WBA Super Middleweight Championship of the World. And now, ladies and gentlemen in attendance and boxing fans joining us around the world, live from Oakland, California, it's Showtime! Introducing to you first, the challenger on my left, fighting out of the red corner, wearing red, white, and blue trunks, the Bay Area Kid and boxing's pride of Oakland, California. He weighed in at a trim and ready 166.5 pounds. He is undefeated in his campaign with a record of 20 wins, no losses, 13 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the 2004 Olympic gold medalist and the WBA number one world rank contender, introducing the undefeated Andre S.O.G. Opponent across the ring, the defending world champion on my right, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the colors of the Danish flag, white trunks with red trim, and fighting out of Copenhagen, Denmark. He weighed in at 167 pounds with an outstanding record of 42 wins and only one loss. He has 32 big wins coming by way of knockout tonight in his 10th straight world title bout. Ladies and gentlemen, here is the two-time and current WBA super middleweight champion of the world, known as the Viking Warrior, introducing Mikael Kessler. Once again, a referee in charge, Jack Reese, now to give instructions.
Everybody out except the 2 second. Get these guys out. Mike, get these guys out. Get them out. Dan, it's time. Let's go.
Let's go, Andre. Oh, shit.
I need everybody out except him. Everybody outside except him. No. Only him. All right, I gave you guys instructions in the dressing room. I just want to remind you, listen and obey my commands at all times. Protect yourself at all times. Fight hard, fight clean. Good luck to both of you. Touch him up.
Oracle Arena in Oakland, California. Mikko Kessler, the champion. He's fought some very tough fighters. Roberto Andrade, Edison Miranda, and the great Joe Calzaghe, 72 world championship rounds. Meanwhile, Andre Ward told us the final transformation from boxer to fighter will take place tonight.
Ready? Ready?
Round one.
Kessler expects Andre Ward to come after him in these first few rounds. He is expecting to have to counterpunch. Ward wants to get the jab established, and he is doing it early out in this fight. And one of the other key things, all Super 6 fights are supposed to be contested in a 20-foot ring. This one is an 18-foot ring inside. Both men agreed to that provision.
Not a lot of room in there. What kind of impact will the size of the ring have on this fight, Antonio?
I think it'll do well for Andre, because if any one of these fighters are able to move, you know, and be versatile, it'll be Andre. I mean, he's known for his quick feet.
Andre Ward has started out this fight landing jabs and left hooks very, very well. So that's a good sign. And already we see him switch.
Ward told us in our fighter meeting that he will go to the body. He doesn't think that Kessler likes to catch it to the body. And he will go there early and often, and he will eventually sit inside and go right at the champion.
Also a reminder, Mikkel Kessler often starts slowly in fights. We saw it, Antonio, in the fight we did with Guzmir Perdomo. There was a little feeling out process. First round or two, Perdomo did very well. So he's not always very effective in the first couple of rounds.
No, he's not. And, you know, he takes his time. He set up and measure his guy. He sees what he can get away with. And then he executes. So that is a sign of a veteran fighter, veteran champion.
Kessler cutting off the ring. Backing Ward into the corner. And Ward ties him up, takes him for a walk. 118 to go in the first round of 12 for the WBA super middleweight title here at the Super 6 World Boxing Classic in Oakland. Stiff jab by Ward. And he goes upstairs, then the jab to the body. Kessler answering with that jab right to the solar plexus. Kessler moving forward, classic European fighter. And the fans start to chant USA.
There's the jab of Kessler. It's an underused weapon sometimes, and he's going to need it in this fight. This is the way round one was supposed to go for Andre Ward, though. He's got to feel good about this round. This is just the way he imagined it.
Most definitely. And coming in as the challenger, it's very important that you dictate in that first round that you're not going anywhere, that you're here for the long haul.
Ward very relaxed, just missed with a straight left hand. 10 seconds to go in the first of 12 rounds. Ward southpaw again, lead left hand connecting on the chin of Kessler. And that's it. Let's take a look at Al Bernstein's keys to the fight.
For Andre Ward, he needs to establish early, and he did that he can make Kessler work and make him think, but he can't take too many chances against Kessler, who is a master counterpuncher. Kessler has been hurt to the body, and Ward is an excellent body puncher. This needs to be in his repertoire, and it was in round one. For Mikkel Kessler, his jab is one of the best in boxing. Sometimes it's an underused weapon. When he throws combinations, Kessler is just an offensive machine. This is really important for him. Didn't do that in round one. The fight changer for Kessler is his quick and powerful right hand, a punch that Ward was hit with against Edison Miranda.
So Mikkel Kessler in his last fight on September 12th, Kessler retained his WBA super middleweight title with a fourth round TKO of Guzmir Perdomo in Denmark. That same night, 5,600 miles away, in his first Super 6 opponent, Andre Ward had similar success against Shelby Pudwell in a three round TKO.
I think one of the big stories so far in this fight has been the left hook of Andre Ward, which is landing much more than I would have anticipated it landing.
Well, he said he was going to definitely get in here and throw all of his repertoire at Kessler tonight. I'm just impressed with the fact that, you know, he's not fighting like a challenger. He's fighting as if he belongs in this event and that he's going to look to become the favorite after tonight to win it all.
And, of course, as we point out, Kessler often starts slowly, and we haven't seen a Kessler right hand get there yet. That'll be the true test. Can Andre Ward take that right hand from Kessler?
Kessler, a very active fighter, loves to throw combinations. Ward, successful, as you mentioned, Al, with that left hook. It's kind of a check.
Step away from each other.
Hook,
step
out. Pivot hook. Same kind of punch that you saw Floyd Mayweather Jr. knock out Ricky Hatton with. Kessler, straight line, still the aggressor from the very beginning. Ward, light on his feet.
Kessler has not been able to get off very well in this fight. That's what the word people hoped for. And so far, at least, that's been the case. Just enough movement, just enough trickery, just enough changing by Andre Ward to make life a little difficult for Mikkel Kessler.
And, you know, it's still early. And
yes,
I think Kessler is fighting the right style in order to put the necessary pressure on Andre Ward just in case if he gets tired or weathers down the stretch.
Probably the only thing Kessler would want to do, and there he goes to the body, is use the jab more, and he's starting to do that. You know, it's not as if Ward doesn't get trapped against the ropes from time to time in this fight. So Kessler's got him in punching range on occasion.
Stop. My brain.
Kessler very focused, doing a solid job of cutting off the ring as Ward switches back to southpaw. Ward finishes off low. Keep that in mind as this fight wears on. He keeps his hands low and finishes low. And Kessler will look to time it.
Let him go, Mikkel. Let him go. Your hands are free, fellas.
Double jab landing for Ward. As we come to the end of the second round, uppercut also getting in. Big right hand landing, and this time Kessler ties up Andre Ward. And the challenger takes a long look at the champion as he walks back to his stool as if to say, my confidence is growing.
Using a full array of weapons. And this one, I don't think everybody expected to be as effective. There's kind of a half left hook, half jab as a counterpunch that lands against Kessler. So there have been many varieties of looks and many varieties of punches by Andre Ward.
Start backing him up subtly, okay?
Yep.
Okay? Stay alert in there. Keep rolling. Let him keep holding you. Let him keep holding you. Let him keep holding you. Let's go. Relax, relax.
Round three for the WBA super middleweight title. Mikkel Kessler, the champion in the white and orange trunks. Andre Ward, the challenger in the red, white, and blue.
Step out from each other.
The hand speed of Andre Ward, obviously, is the difference in this fight. That and the combination punching. Kessler is normally a good combination puncher. He is not putting his punches together well.
He is not, and you know what? He's going to have to make some adjustments here. He just can't let Andre have his way from the outside, which we thought Kessler would have a better chance of getting his style off from the outside.
You know, I think Mikkel Kessler's big problem is he's just not accurate with his punches. Let's give Andre Ward some credit for that. There are opportunities there that he is not seizing.
Kessler having a problem right now with Ward's speed.
Yep. And Ward's mostly his hand speed.
Ward's head and shoulder movement has also thrown off Kessler.
And let's not forget the foot speed as well. I mean, Ward is in and out before Kessler can get set. You know, that's why he can't land the big shot right now.
One thing Ward pointed out is that he and his camp feel that Kessler has a hard time making adjustments, especially after the fifth or sixth round.
Well, that's what they're banking on. They're banking on that they can continue to cruise like this without getting hit with the big shot from Kessler.
Straight right hand, very stiff, getting through for Andre Ward.
Stop. Andre Ward is a very, and the inside is a tough fighter to deal with. Sometimes he punches and sometimes he just uses that as a defense in a way and doesn't get hurt on the inside. They don't believe Kessler fights well on the inside. Now, there was a Kessler jab. We have not seen much of that. And we haven't seen almost one good, really good right hand from Kessler yet in this fight.
Kessler trying to find his distance.
I mean, those right hands,
that last one
missed by a foot. You know, that's amazing.
They tell us in boxing, if you can't hit a guy with a jab, you can forget about hitting him with the right hand.
Yes, that is true.
Stop, punch, stop. Andre, stop. Step out. Box.
Yes, baby. Yes, baby. Oh, there's another good right hand by Ward. Kessler comes back, though, with the stiff jab. Ward going downstairs. He's been going high-low since the very beginning. Third round scheduled for 12.
Kessler now using that jab a little more, and that may help him, as we said, as a rangefinder for the right at some point.
We come to the end of the third round.
Stop. Quick.
Let's go to Jen Brown, who's standing by with Andre Ward's family.
Thanks, Gus. I'm here with Tiffany, Andre's wife. Now, Tiffany, you know Andre better than anybody. What's the pressure like being here, fighting at home in front of family and friends for his first attempt at a world championship title?
It's a tremendous pressure. He's fighting for his family. He's fighting for the Lord. Obviously, it's his hometown, but he welcomes the pressure. He's ready. He's trained his whole life for this.
It's not always easy being a wife of a fighter. Tell me how you deal with, you're sitting here watching him fight, being separated through the training.
It's been a long, I think about 8 weeks, but we've been doing this for a long time. It is tough sometimes. I've got to be mom and dad, but we get through it.
And what does a win tonight mean for you and your family?
It means everything. Like I said, he's been training for this day his whole life. It means everything for all of us. We know it's going to take his career to the next level.
Well, good luck to you guys tonight. Thank you so much. Now let's head back over to Gus.
All right, Jen. Fourth round, scheduled for 12, a mouse under the right eye of Mikkel Kessler. Andre Ward not only fights for his family, he fights for his father, Frank Ward, who was 15-0 as a heavyweight. Used to tell his son stories of his boxing days. He passed away in 2002 when Andre was 16 years old.
And you know, Andre Ward, early on in his professional career, had issues. Darnell Boone knocked him down in his sixth pro fight, had him in trouble, and he won a very close decision. That has dogged him a little bit as he's gone out as a pro. And the Kessler people really felt like their man would be able to hurt him. But this is a whole different Andre Ward. This is a confident Andre Ward. And one who is fighting like a champion, as Antonio said, because he's making Kessler come to him.
Up a little bit.
And let's take a look at press row scoring through three.
Michael Engard of the Ulan Posten from Denmark and Robert Huff from the fightnews.com and Monty Poole from the Oakland Tribune all appropriately see it 30-27 for Andre Ward. There doesn't seem to be any other way to score those first three rounds, as I have it scored.
So Kessler behind his only loss coming to Joe Calzaghe, a unanimous decision for the great Joe Calzaghe.
You know, there are little things a fighter can build on when he's fighting. Not much has gone right for Kessler, but there is one punch he's been able to land. That is that sharp right hand to the body.
Yes.
If he at least could continue to throw that punch, it might open up other opportunities.
I truly believe that this fight will have some ebb and flow in it. Kessler will find the mark eventually. I didn't think that Kessler would win these early rounds. So, you know, because Kessler said himself in the fighters' meeting, if Andre Ward can stand there and fight, I don't have to look for him, and that plays into my hand.
You know, big left hook landed by Kessler, and I'll tell you, there's another pattern emerging here. Jack Rice, I believe, nice right by Ward.
Kessler is hurt as he backs up and ties up Ward. Ward going after him now, punches and bunches. And Kessler just steps back and uses his jab. He's trying to clear his head.
The point I was going to make is Jack Rice, the referee, is allowing Ward to hold a lot on the inside. And that's something that we're going to have to look at, because that's really helping him a lot not have to deal with some of that power of Kessler.
Now blood coming out of that mouth under the right eye of Kessler. Ward closing in. Kessler takes a huge right hand and buckled him. Kessler backing up now.
He's cut over the right eye.
Ward smelling it. Steps in using his speed. End of the round. And this has been the best round for Andre Ward. Switches to southpaw. Lands a straight left hand. And Andre Ward getting the champion in major trouble in the fourth round.
Are you all right, Lily? You have to control him with your left. Don't let him move around you. Cut him off. Open up with your left and then use your right, okay? Keep counter-attacking him.
It's a butt. It's from a butt. There's a right hand that opened it, but the butt started.
Andre Ward, from this posture, look at, he held on the inside and then was able to rip shots on the inside. Kessler, not a fighter that likes to fight on the inside, and not doing too much offensively, and those shots on the inside by Ward, very, very effective.
Round five, scheduled for 12, the WBA super middleweight title on the line. The champion is Mikkel Kessler from Copenhagen in the white and orange. Andre Ward, the American, red, white, and blue, coming off his best round in the fourth, where he buckled Kessler. There's another right hand by Ward. He's relaxed. And right now, it's target practice. And Antonio Kessler seems like his feet are planted in cement. He can't get close enough.
Well, you know, that was the scouting report on him. You know, they saw that Joe Calzacchi was able to utilize his speed and foot speed to offset Kessler's aggression. And look, the same thing has happened tonight. Andre Ward has arrived. The Olympic gold medalist is showing people that he is just as talented as the very best super middleweight in the world.
Mikkel Kessler's face now really starting to look bad. He has a cut under the right eye, and he may be bleeding under his from his mouth, rather.
You know, the interesting thing is that Ward is slipping.
Let him go, Mikkel. Let him go,
Mikkel. Every one of these punches. His ability defensively, very, very effective.
There's another great left hook by Andre Ward. And as he told us, Antonio, the transformation from boxer to fighter will be complete tonight.
Yes, and what I'm looking at is the transformation is that he's trying to put hurt on Kessler. He wants to win this fight in emphatic fashion by stopping the WBA champion tonight.
Now, two things have happened in this round. Kessler's starting to find a home for his left hook a little bit, and that's at least helped him climb back a smidge in this round. And we want to remind you all that, you know, in our last telecast, we had a text poll question in which we asked who would win this fight, and 54% said Andre Ward would, in fact, win this fight. So a lot of the fans were behind him, and a number of the pundits have picked him as well. But, of course, we're early, and Mikkel Kessler has plenty of fight left in him, and there he lands a big jab.
And that was a strong body punch by Kessler on the rope.
Nice jab by Ward.
You can feel the urgency in Kessler. You can just feel him say, I've got to attack no matter what with abandon.
Here's a good jab by Kessler. Straight left hand connecting for Ward. He keeps pawing with that right hand when he switches to southpaw. And now he's even hooking off the jab.
And you know, they did not spar with any lefties. Mikkel Kessler said we sparred with all righties. They didn't assume Ward would be lefty this much in the fight. So that could be a big factor.
It has confused Mikkel Kessler. Absolutely right out. Into the fifth round. Andre Ward continuing to roll.
Time,
Antonio, the jab of Andre Ward was something that he really wanted to establish, and boy, he did here, didn't he?
Yes, he did. He was concentrating on that jab, and he's trying to put it all together tonight. But I must say, it's still early. It's midway through, and Kessler is a champion. Andre Ward can't get too comfortable because everything is going his way. He still needs to be mindful of the power.
And ringside, the great Herschel Walker, NFL Hall of Famer, will make his MMA debut January 30th. Still in incredible shape.
Any sport that he hasn't tried, he's won a medal as a bobsledder. It's amazing.
Don't do it, Herschel.
Walker in his mid-40s, still with that competitive spirit. Round six, scheduled for 12.
Who would have thought, honestly, even among the people that picked Andre Ward to win, that he would be pitching a shutout, which he most assuredly is, at this juncture in the fight. And as Antonio rightfully pointed out, Mikel Kessler is still right there and certainly a big power puncher who can still land something to change this fight. But to this point, Andre Ward has done everything he's supposed to do.
Yes.
Mikel Kessler, so far, ABC fighter. Let's see if he does make an adjustment.
Oh,
Andre Ward just missing with that can opener.
Nice left hook by Kessler.
Yes.
On the way out there.
Exactly. And that came from wildness from Andre Ward. If Andre Ward gets reckless, look at how he's lunging in, Andre Ward. That's a big mistake.
He needs to tighten it up right now to know that this fight is not out of reach for Kessler, and he still has to be on his P's and Q's.
You are so right. He is attacking in a very bad fashion right now, leaving himself wide open, and Kessler's a very good counterpuncher. A very surprising lack of discipline this round in some ways by Andre Ward. Now, Kessler hasn't been able to take advantage so much of it yet.
Mikel Kessler, 42-1, 32 KOs.
Get your arm out of there, Andre. Get your arm out of there.
Antonio, Andre Ward fights like a grizzled veteran. He holds on the inside. Look at him land the uppercut. He has all the veteran tricks on the inside.
Yes, he do, and I'm not surprised. This guy doesn't know how to lose. He hadn't lost since he was 12 years old. He won the only gold medal for the USA in the Olympics in Athens. And I mean, I'm not surprised. This guy has all the tools.
120 amateur fights for Ward, only 47 for Kessler. There's a right hand followed by a jab by Ward that got through.
And shame on Kessler if he doesn't take advantage of some of these lapses by Andre Ward. Because Ward has been attacking kind of recklessly, but Kessler's not really taking advantage of that.
Ward going downstairs to the body with the jab, now doubling up the jab rather, up top. As he steps off, Kessler, nice right hand.
Stop.
That left hook blocked, though, by Ward as he tried to dig to the body.
And doubling up on a jab, that's a hook that Kessler just landed. He's reaching. Doubling up on a jab will serve Kessler well because he's just not getting there with one jab. He's not getting there.
Boy, are you right. And, you know, Mikel Kessler's not the greatest left hook artist, but that's the punch that's available to him tonight, so he better start throwing it.
Now Ward pursuing. Kessler expected this.
Let it go, Mikel. Let him go. Fight out. Fight. Stop. My boy.
Wait, it is true. Mikel Kessler just does not like fighting on the inside at all.
There's a straight right hand right on the chin of Kessler. Ward again. Using that head and shoulder movement. Andre Ward finding success.
You are a champion. Come on now. Feeling good? Tell me, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Huh? We got another gear when we need it?
Yep.
He's starting to get tired, Dre. Can you keep
in the last round, Andre Ward made some mistakes, but they weren't capitalized on. Here, look at the way he's coming and leaving himself wide open. Just no head movement and lunging kind of in. Kessler did nothing with that. However, later in the round, Ward was able to land that big jab as he lunged in. And Kessler's still not countering there with the left hook as he might have.
Round seven. Scheduled for 12. Mikel Kessler, the WBA champion, against Andre Ward, Olympic gold medalist in 2004. Actually moved up in weight to win that gold medal. naturally 165 pounder at that time. He fought at 178.
In our press row scoring, interestingly, they all gave the last round to Nickel Kessler. And that was round five, and that was the only round, they gave to Nickel Kessler. And it's the only round that they have given to Kessler in the fight.
You know, as we spoke with Kessler in the fighters'
right,
meeting, I sensed the feel that he had a little bit of superiority feeling going into this fight. Could he have possibly taken Andre Ward a little lightly just because he didn't have the marquee names on his resume?
It's an interesting point, and that would be the reason, wouldn't it? Everybody has downgraded Edison Miranda, even though he was once a very fine middleweight, but he's lost to a lot of the super middleweights in this tournament, so they didn't feel even that was a quality win.
Nice jab.
See what Ward's doing.
Ward with another good jab. Trying to go with the uppercut now. Missing.
You know, the way to accurately describe this, in my opinion, Gus, is that Kessler is at a flat performance.
Let him go, Miguel.
It's just
fight
been
out, boys.
Flat. He hasn't done the things that he's capable of doing. Some of that's due to Andre Ward, and some of it's due to just the fact that he just has not been sharp.
He's just too much speed right now for Kessler.
And that's what it is. I mean, Andre Ward is a seasoned guy. He's young. He's youthful. And that's what's getting him by right now. But let's face it, the fight is not over yet.
Oh, no.
But if it continues like this, this will be an easy win in the bag for Andre.
Now, there's three straight jabs by Kessler, and two of the three landed. And that's what can set up something for him.
And you see Andre Ward's hand is still dropping. He's getting a little bit careless, and he's doing a lot of things in there because he's gaining confidence. Let's hope that's not his downfall.
Yeah, let that arm go.
You know,
come on, guys, fight out.
When you out-jab a jabber, you take that punch away from him. And that's what Ward has essentially done to Nickel Kessler.
Kessler, uncharacteristically, with a wild left hand.
Stop.
Now he's starting to gamble a little bit. 40 seconds to go in the seventh round.
That was the first right uppercut that Kessler has thrown. That's the punch that Boone knocked down Ward with in his sixth pro fight. It was an essential punch, in my opinion, on the inside for Kessler. First time he threw it, and here we are in round seven. So there are some tactical errors by Mickel Kessler that have hurt him as well.
Ward going back to the jab. Now he goes downstairs again. How effective is that jab? Right on top of the belt buckle.
Very effective. You know what? He's made this fight easy with that jab tonight. He's controlled the fight.
And Ward, another stern look into the eyes of Mickel Kessler.
You got to move to the sides, Mickel. Use your left to open up. I can't see.
Taking a lot of good shots.
No problem. Good chance that kid couldn't bust his wrist.
Maybe that's part of it, huh?
He's hungry in the back.
Mickel Kessler has been reduced in this fight to this. Now, the left hook is the punch that can land. Look at how much he missed with that punch, and look at how wide it was, Antonio, thrown very poorly.
Yeah, that's not a mark of a champion right there. It's a mark of desperation.
All right.
And not what he usually does.
Let's fill you in. Jim Gray just came to me and told us that Mickel Kessler told his trainer that he can't see. And he's squinting out of the left eye. That jab really consistently in the face of Mickel Kessler.
Ooh, nice short right hand by Kessler. That's one of the few he's thrown.
There's another right hand by Ward.
Ward is standing up. Ward's right in front of him.
Right in front of him.
But he has got such confidence, he feels he can make that work.
And his confidence is gaining. If Kessler wants to change this fight, he's going to have to double jab to get closer.
You're so right.
Looks like Kessler is weakening as this fight continues.
Bullshit.
Complaining about eye problems, lack of vision. Ward now moving forward. Here's where the boxer transforms into the fighter. He wants to finish the world champion in his hometown.
And now it's Kessler holding on the inside. side, and he's doing that to buy time, to get himself some moments. It's just intriguing. There's a right to the body. Remember, Joe Calzaghe hurt Kessler with body shots later in their fight.
And now you look at Kessler with all those body shots he's taken. His hands are starting to come down a bit. Ward setting him up.
Ward says that he wants to end this fight.
Let him go, Mikel.
Shortly.
Fight out,
I mean, he's doing everything he wants.
Stop.
Nothing is coming back from Kessler. So what does he have to be afraid of in going in there and landing all out on the line?
This kind of dominant performance, not expected, I don't think, by most people, even though many picked Andre Ward, many felt he had a good chance to win this fight.
Kessler circling now.
I'll push his face.
Blood coming out of his nose, a cut under his right eye.
Stop. Break.
The big question, of course, is how much does Andre Ward now go into a four corners offense a little bit and not take too many chances?
Stop.
But you
Please
made the point,
stop.
Antonio. He's such
That's
a confident
it.
Young man. He wants to make a statement, and he's thinking maybe about that extra point in this tournament. You get a knockout, you get 3 points.
Most definitely. And you know what? He fights every round as if it's the last. Every round is a championship round for Andre Ward, and that is a good mark for a young fighter coming up today. Don't take any rounds off. Do everything you can to secure victory.
That sequence is this fight in microcosm. Kessler threw about 8 punches and landed none.
Ward advancing. Kessler backing up. And that's the end of the round.
I can't see.
Wow, look at the blood coming out of Kessler's eye. He is severely cut over the left eye, and that might do this fight if they can't fix it up. Kessler has never been stopped.
Can you see him? Yeah, but I can't see. You gotta stop him. Should we stop the fight? No.
And the blood dripping in his eye.
Keep up your hands now. You can only win by knockout now.
Mikkel Kessler told by Richard Olsen he can only win by knockout. Severely cut over his left eye, under his right eye. Ward advancing, feeling the victory.
Malcolm Garrett, a terrific cut man in the corner, but there was only so much he could do with that cut.
Ward using that jab.
It's sad to say, but Mikkel Kessler was telling his corner that he couldn't see. His trainer sent him back out there and said that he needs a knockout in order to win this fight. He's looking for a way out of this fight.
And Ward wants to give him a way out of this fight.
Stop,
ninth
stop,
round, scheduled for 12, the WBA super middleweight title. The champion in trouble, Mikkel Kessler, as Andre Ward in red, white, and blue from Oakland, California, continues to advance. He's used the jab, going upstairs, going downstairs. He's pot-shotted him with straight right hands. He's tried to land the uppercut. Kessler backing up.
Stop.
One of the interesting things here, we have seen the Europeans win, of course, the first two matches in this tournament. And in this case, the man we thought was the supreme European is having the most trouble.
Mikkel Kessler favored.
Let him go, Mikkel, let
in
him go.
This tournament.
Co-favored with Abraham, but certainly considered a potential winner. And may still be, just no matter what happens.
Kessler's face, bloodied, bruised. He's having trouble with his vision. He told his trainer, Richard Olsen, he can't see. But he did say he wanted to continue for Andre Ward. He looks like he just took a light jog in the park. A minute to go in the ninth round.
Kessler is an 11-year veteran in this sport. He suffered elbow injuries, back injuries, hand injuries. He's a fighter who, you know, at this juncture, some would suggest, has had enough issues so that he could be wearing down a bit. Maybe that's a factor here.
Let his arm go.
And there's Andre Ward still working really hard inside. Nothing from Kessler. He just hasn't been able to find his space and his distance tonight due to the great footwork of Andre Ward.
Kessler is a wonderful fighter almost all situations, not tonight.
Andre Ward following in the footsteps of former great Olympic gold medalist.
Ooh.
Cassius Clay, Joe Frazier, George Foreman, Sugar Ray Leonard, Oscar De La Hoya in 92. Coming out party with a world title on the line. End of the round.
Stop. Break, clean.
How's the eye? Tell me if you wanted to stop.
I'm not taking any time for you. I'm calling time. Let him step out. Just let him look in the eye. No time you lose. Let him just look at him. Malcolm, listen. I want you to explain something. Listen to me. Look at me. I want you to explain to him that he's holding. I say let go.
If
you guys shut up and listen. If he's holding, I say let go. He can still fight. If I say stop, he stops.
In round 8, this is where we believe the cut came from. Well, looks like it could have been a clash of heads that created that cut, an accidental clash of heads, which would mean in any case they would go to the scorecards even if they called that, and certainly Ward would be way ahead, but it appears that's how that cut happened.
Kessler breathing out of his mouth shows that he is fatigued. Andre Ward telling us, all I see is this belt. I don't see the tournament points and so on. There is no next fight for me.
10 seconds. Go back.
I want to become a world champion.
Well, it looks like they gave Kessler about an extra 15 seconds.
Well, I mean, that was the referee's doing. He was just, you know, taking his time there. But the thing is that even with that clash of heads, which was not, we should point out, it was not ruled a clash of heads. So right now, if he would lose for that cut, because of that cut, it would be a TKO victory for Andre Ward. And even if they had ruled that they would be going to the scorecards, if this fight was stopped, then surely Ward would be ahead at that point. But that cut is an issue. A big one. Ooh, stiff jab by Andre Ward. It's almost as if he has a stick in his with a bowling ball on the end of it. He's really using his back to snap that jab and land on the champion. Kessler has had trouble cutting up. There was a bang of heads, and you can feel the pain of Kessler.
So if that particular injury would stop this match, they would go to the scorecards. But it would have to be that injury.
Oh. That was a good exchange there. He did catch Ward coming in. And he's having some success this round as did he had in the last round. So credit to Kessler. He hasn't given up his belt just yet.
Nice right hand by Kessler. He's starting to get a few big punches in here.
Could it be enough to do anything to turn
this fight around? Clearly, he does need a knockout to win or a series of knockdowns in these last few rounds. He has had 3 knockouts, Kessler has, in the last 3 rounds of fights in 10, 11, and 12 in his career.
That jab again, really hurting Kessler. Kessler backing up. Nice combination by Andre Ward.
Let it go, both you guys.
The champion really weakening now.
Let's talk some tournament strategy for a second. Kessler wants to stay through the 12 rounds so he doesn't give Ward 3 points as well. But can he?
Andre Ward also doing a good job when they're tied up, working the free hand. Just landed an uppercut there.
me go out on a limb and say, if Andre Ward's fight with this type of intensity for 12 rounds, he's going to be hard to beat for anyone in this tournament.
Stop.
He's fighting very well. So relaxed. Calm. Andre Ward. As we come to the end of the round. Kessler in major trouble. Dr. Smith, Ketchum in Kessler's corner.
Time, just get a lot of time out. I mean, no, you're not going to lose any time. Stop. Take a look at the second one. It's a head bump.
Super big head bump. It's not that bad. You're not even bleeding.
To say stop if you want to stop. I don't want to stop. He keeps holding me. Use your left.
In the last round, there was yet another clash of heads. And Jack Rice, oh my, well, Andre Ward came in like a billy goat on that one, let's be honest. And Kessler hurt by it. Now, later on, Ward using his hand speed very effectively, even if in an awkward fashion.
Championship rounds for the WBA Super Middleweight title here at the Super 6 World Boxing Classic. Andre Ward in red, white, and blue. Mikkel Kessler in the white and orange. And the doctor gave Kessler extra time in the last two rounds to look at the cut.
Kessler is 4-1 in 12-round matches, and Andre Ward is 2-0. We're in the championship rounds, as you mentioned.
I take my hat off to Kessler. You know, and asking him, does he want to quit? They say they're not going to stop this fight unless he say he can't go on. And like a champion, he's coming back out to defend his title. And it's not over until it's over. That's one thing about boxing.
It's a very good point, Antonio, and well put. Andre Ward said, I'm going to do what's least expected of me in this fight at every moment. And really, he has. He's mixed up his attack and kept Kessler completely confused during most of this fight.
Antonio,
stop.
The jab to the body, the belt line. Why has it been so effective for Andre Ward?
You know, it's just one of those things that keeps Kessler at bay. I mean, sticking a jab into your solar plexus, Floyd Mayweather is an expert at that. He does it all the time. Roy Jones Jr. was a great fighter did that, kept his opponents at bay, and then it lines him up for the overhand right over top of it.
Lead right hand. Connecting for Ward.
Andre Ward is taking every chance in the world and getting away with it. Kessler not able to get it.
It's on the eyelid now. It's on the eyelid. Hands around. See where it's at? You okay with that?
Let's stop it.
Right now.
And it's over. Andre Ward is the new WBA Super Middleweight Champion of the World as he stops Mikkel Kessler here at the Super 6 World Boxing Classic. He chopped him up from the very beginning. But in all likelihood, unless there is one of the greatest robberies since the Brinks, clearly that young man will be champion and will win a match and get 3 points in this tournament.
Mikkel Kessler with that huge cut over his eye. Also a cut under his right eye. Antonio, Al, it seemed as if he could never really find his rhythm in this fight.
Yeah, and a lot of that has to do with Andre Ward's movement. We said he was going to approach this fight like a junk pitcher in baseball. Throw a little of this, a little of that, and make it work. And a good example of the faith of Andre Ward.
Yes, the faith and the belief that this was his promise from his God, that this night was destined.
So the headbutts are a key to this fight. We'll go to round eight first.
This was the clash of heads that the referee Jack Weiss did not see, but it created a cut around the left eye of Nickel Kessler. Clearly it was an issue for him for several rounds, but this is the one that Jack Rice did see and immediately said it was a clash of heads. And you could see how Ward came in, and honestly, that head was first, and he blasted Kessler with it. This is the one that actually caused the fight to be stopped ultimately, and Jack Rice appropriately, because that was the cut that stopped the fight, said it should go to the scorecards.
Now we assume that Ward had a pretty big lead, but we will soon find out here at the Oracle Arena in Oakland, California. Some concern ringside. Andre Ward's wife, Tiffany.
She knows enough about boxing though to know that if they go to the cards, her husband may well win.
And we are ready for the decision. Let's go inside the ring to Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, this bout has been stopped at the time of 1 minute, 42 seconds in round number 11 due to a headbutt which occurred earlier in the bout and was subsequently reopened during the fight at round number 11. Our ringside physician determines the fighter is unable to continue. Therefore, we go to the scorecards with a technical decision. Ladies and gentlemen, at the mark, the judges have the bout scored as followed. Judge Michael Hook sees the bout 97-93. Stanley Christodoulou and Steve Morrow both score the bout 98-92. All three in favor of the winner by way of technical decision. And the new WBA super middleweight champion of the world, Andre
and now WBA super middleweight title holder. All the hard work paying off for Andre Ward. And I'm sure that somewhere Frank Ward, his dad, is watching and is very proud of his son. On the other side, a frustrated former champion in Mikkel Kessler.
In a million years, he did not expect this to happen.
Now let's go inside the ring to Jim Gray.
All right, thank you very much, Gus. Andre, congratulations to you. You told us yesterday you've been preparing this for this since you were 9 years old. This moment is like what for you now?
For what it's worth, Jim, please give me my moment. I have to thank God for this because he constantly puts me up against giants. He puts me in situations where naturally I'm not supposed to overcome, but I'm telling you that God, there's nothing impossible with Jesus Christ in your life, nothing. To answer your question, I just felt like it was my time, Jim, and I wasn't intimidated by Kessler's record because I know that, again, if God is with you, who can be against you?
You felt that he was not able to adjust in his fight against Calzaghe, right, and you saw a trend there.
Right.
Did you feel that from about the second and third round on that you were going to be effective with what you were doing and that he couldn't combat it?
You're absolutely right. I was kind of surprised. I mean, I knew that going in, but being in there, I was surprised he didn't make the adjustments. He kind of kept doing the same thing over and over, but taking nothing away from him, he's a super champion, and I know why he's been champion for so long.
What enabled you, in your mind, to totally dominate this fight from moment one?
Again, I felt like I was here for a reason. my church family, and I was getting tons of texts, tons of letters, and they were all confirming. People were saying the same thing. It's your time. Go get what's rightfully yours. You've been training for a long time. Go get it. And then Verge, man, this is as much for me as it is for Virgil, because he's a world-class trainer. He has a gold medalist, and now he has a world champion, and he knows how to keep me focused in that fight from round to round.
Andre, stay with us. Let us talk to Mikel before he leaves the ring, and we'll get back to you in just a moment. Mikel, what is your assessment of what happened here this evening?
I'm not used to that that the referee don't stop the fight when you're holding, and he was using his headbutt all the time. Every time he got in, he headbutted me. And every time I tried to do like this, he let him punch me. I'm not used to that.
Mikel, do you believe that was the difference in the fight?
Yes, of course. Of course, he hits me sometimes because I get out of rhythm. But still, I think that it was unfair with the headbutt and the holding and a home judge referee. How do you say?
Jack Reese did tell me that he felt that there were 5 accidental headbutts, that there were no intentional headbutts in it. Let's take a look, Mikel, at the one from round 8 from your perspective. Tell us what you feel and see.
Yeah.
Right there.
Yeah. He's going in with his head at me all the time on purpose.
You believe it's on purpose? You believe it was intentional?
Yeah, but he's coming in with a headbutt all the time. Also, when I look, you can see he's coming in with his head all the time. He knows I'm not moving, he's coming in with his head. And then we're holding, he's punching.
You said after the 7th round, you told your trainer that you could not see. Yeah. How much was it affecting you and your ability to fight?
I could not see on my eyes. When I got the headbutt, it's like flaring a little bit. But so I tried to do something else, but the referee was in the corner in between the rounds. He was saying, okay, I'm not going to break you now, but he didn't.
You haven't lost since this loss to Calzaghe back in 2007, and you were the favorite coming into this tournament. What will you do now to reassess and get ready for your next fight with Carl Frage?
Of course, I have to look at how the fight went on at tape, see what I can do better, and see if I still got it. Of course,
you're going to have to assess that. And what about the cuts? Do you feel as though that they may give you your cuts, all of these cuts? Do you feel as though that might be a problem going forward?
Yeah, maybe. You know, if I have to fight a war again someday, I have to. I cannot go straight forward or stay in the middle. I have to go to the sides.
Mikel, thank you very much. We appreciate it.
Okay.
All right, Andre. So now you advance here into the 2nd round, and your next fight will be against Taylor if he elects to continue. I know it's probably too early to start thinking about that. However, he now finds himself in a circumstance, having lost 3 of his last 4 fights, knocked out twice in a row. He can get a title now by fighting you. So do you believe that he will continue now because of the opportunity?
That's up to him. You know, I read a Twitter where he said he answered his fans and said that he was training and preparing. So that's what we'll get ready for. Whoever it is, I mean, we fought the best in the world tonight. We fought the guy that a lot of people thought I got a bad draw. And we told everybody that, no, this is the right draw. So we beat the top guy. We're going to rest a little bit. It was a hard training camp, and it's been a long 15 years. And I'm going to regroup, get ready for the next stage, whoever it is.
Jack Reese told me that he felt that there were 5 unintentional headbutts. Mikel Kessler, the referee this evening, Kessler just said that he felt that they were intentional, and that was the difference in the fight. What about all of these headbutts?
Well, I'll let the fans and the announcers and everybody be the judge.
What's your assessment, okay, though?
My assessment is I think I felt two accidental headbutts. Totally, I'm not a dirty fighter. If you check any of my 20 fights, I've never done that intentionally. He has 3 cuts. 2 of them were punches for sure. 1 of them was a headbutt. So you can't say anything about the other moments in the other 10 rounds. I mean, what can you say about that? I mean, you know, but again, I take nothing away from him. He's a great champion.
All right, congratulations to you, Andre. I know tonight is the culmination of a lifetime of work, and now you're a champion. Congratulations.
I'm glad you're able to cover my fight, man. You're a legend in my mind. Thank you very much.
Thank you. I appreciate that as well. Back to you, Gus.
All right, let's take a look at the scoring for Kessler Ward, the official judges' scorecards.
And, of course, these were the official scores because they went to the scorecards after that clash of heads. Michael Hook, of course, the Swedish judge, had it the closest at 97-93. Morrow and Chris Dedulu, both veteran judges, had it 98-92.
Press row scoring.
uniform for, including, by the way, the Danish writer Michael Engard, and also Robert Huff from FightNews.com and Monty Poole from right here at the Oakland Tribune. So clearly, everybody saw this fight pretty much the same way.